So my name is Chitra and I work at Mango Education as content manager. So those of you who have attended some of our previous lives would know that I also often moderate the live sessions on our social media channels. So Mango Education is a learning club for kids and we cater to the children between 5 and 15 years of age. So our objective has primarily been to promote scientific temperament and look at science beyond academics and jobs. And we've been exploring various opportunities. When we were in this process, we realized that we could also scale in terms of value creation. So during the initial phase of the lockdown, we started a WhatsApp radio, which evolved into what is today Mango Science Radio. So as part of Mango Science Radio, people who have subscribed to us on WhatsApp receive science stories narrated by passionate educators and scientists from various fields of science. Now Mango Science Radio is a community in itself, and we have listeners who have turned into volunteers. So the same stories that we initially recorded in English are now being translated into other languages like Tamil, Marathi, and Malayalam. We've also had requests for stories in Telugu, Hindi, and Bengali, and we are roping in volunteers. So once we get them, we'll be rolling out stories in these languages as well. So the growth has been largely community-based, and with more than 500 million daily active users on WhatsApp and believers of technology and education instead of edtech, we thought of using it as a platform for spreading science in the right manner. So Mango Science Radio is still a community initiative and we don't charge a fee. Now, among our various contributors, we've had three people who have been consistent and unique with their stories. So we have Satyashree, who is a seed scientist. We've had Obali Chandran, who's a science communicator and educator at Mango Education. And we have Deepa, who is a storyteller and educator here at Mango. So I'm not going to take any more your time and quickly invite Deepa to get started. Yes. Hi, Deepa.
Hi, Chitra.
Welcome to the live. I already introduced you, so I don't think you need any more introduction. And I think you can probably start with the story.
Okay. So if you guys have been listening to Mango Science Radio, you must know of these stories about Samir, Dia, and Surya. They are a group of friends living in an apartment. And the stories are about, basically their experiences with respect to science. So today we have one more story about Samir. Samir is my favorite character. And Samir is this boy who is around 9 to 10 years old, and he also has a brother, and he has his best friend is Dia. So Samir has recently moved to the apartment. So there was a story about how they have recently moved to the house and they had to make a table, etc., and where he had to measure and understand what measurement was. So today, Samir is having another interesting experience. So since he is in this new house, Samir, he went to throw a can. He had had some juice in a can that came in a can, and he went to throw it in the dustbin. So when he went to the place where the dustbins were kept, he saw not one, but three dustbins. Three dustbins? What are three dustbins for? So he opened one, he found some cooked rice, you know, that was wasted, the food that was wasted yesterday, that was put in the dustbin, in that dustbin. Then there in the next dustbin, when he opened, he saw some papers and some plastic cover and a separate plastic cover in which there were some clothes. And then in the third dustbin, there was the banana peels of the bananas that we ate, and there were some onion peels. There were, you know, such things that are vegetable waste and apple peels that were found in that dustbin. So he had no idea where to put his, throw away his can. So he was like, Appa, can you come here, please? I need some help. That's human. What is it? So Samir said, Appa, what do I do with this can? I said, throw it in the dustbin. What else will you do? He said, no. My question is, which dustbin do I throw it in? There are some three dustbins. Why are there three dustbins in our house? So that's it. Samir, this place, this building, they have asked us to segregate the waste, meaning whatever waste we are throwing, they have asked us to separate it into different dustbins. So that is one reason we have put it in it. So Samir was like, why should we separate the waste? Waste is waste. That's it. See, it's basically, you know, easier for the garbage people to collect. That is one thing. But secondly, I've also been thinking that we can start using some of this waste. Wow, do you know what waste means? Waste means things that we don't use, things that are useless. That's why we are throwing it as waste. So how can we use this waste? And Dad said, well, that is something that you have to answer. Why don't you look in these dustbins and tell me what you can use these things for? So Samir opened one dustbin. He saw the clothes there. He said, what do I do with these clothes? Appa, you know what? I can actually cut them and we can use it to wipe the glasses with it, or even the floor. We can use it as a waste cloth. That's it. That's a very good idea. I didn't think of that. What about the papers and the plastic covers? So Samir thought and said, you have put the old clothes in a plastic cover. Similarly, we can use this plastic cover to put other things. Maybe I can put some of my toys. Maybe we could put some vegetables and store it in the fridge in the plastic cover. Or even, you know, take it back to the grocer and say, we don't need another packet. Why don't you refill this packet? That's it. That is wonderful. What about the papers, though? Okay, we can't tell them to take back the papers. Then Samir thought and said, wait a minute. I remember Surya's mom has told we can make paper mash out of old papers. That was it. Paper mash? He said, no, you know, you can soak the paper in water. You can grind it. You can make it into a mulch. And then you can add some glue and things like that and make something out of it. That was like, I didn't even know that was possible. Good, paper mash is a good idea. So that's another way we can use it. And what about the can that you are holding? Samir said, I don't know. Wait a minute. Maybe I could paint it and I could cut off the top and we could use it as a pen stand. He said, that's it. Yes, a pen stand is a great idea. Or maybe you could put two cans together, cut off both sides and use it as a binocular. Yeah. And you said, yeah, that could be. Then I'm saving this can. I'm not throwing it in the waste, said Samir. Then Appa said, but Samir, what about this food? What do we do with this food? And wait a minute, before the food, tell me what to do with the banana waste. You know, the banana peel and the onion peel. Samir said, I have no idea what to do with any of the food waste. You know what? Maybe the banana peels, I can think of something. I've seen cows grazing in the place near our house. Maybe we could put the banana peels for the cows to eat. But I don't know about, I don't think cows eat onion peels, nor will they eat old food. Cooked rice, but so I don't know what to do with those, Appa. Then his dad thought a bit and said, you know what? The food waste that we have, the onion leaves and the carrot scrapes and all those things, we could make a compost out of it. What's a compost, Appa? Asked Samir. So Appa said, compost is where you put it all in a place where there, you know, maybe we could use one of our plastic bins. We make holes in it so that it has some air circulation, and we put all this and put all this waste and some more dry leaves and things like that. Slowly, small organisms that we cannot even see, the microorganisms will start eating it up, and it will all become black and it will get composted, and we could use that as manure for the plants, said Dad. Sami was surprised. He didn't even know something called compost existed. Then he asked, then what can we do with the cooked rice? Can we use that also as the compost? So Dad said, no, Sami, see this, we cannot use it for compost sometimes because it starts smelling very badly. So maybe what we should do is not waste our food while we are eating. But Amma sometimes yesterday had cooked too much. Even when you cook, sometimes you cook too much. We just cannot eat everything. So sometimes it goes to waste. So that's it. Then that's a lesson for us. Then maybe next time I shouldn't cook so much. I should reduce my amount of cooking. Hey, you know, Samir, all your ideas have been fantastic, and they fall into three important things. One, like I said, we could reduce our waste, where we make sure that we don't buy too much. Even the clothes, you know, where we don't buy too much clothes. That way we don't waste too many clothes. We don't make too much food. That way we don't waste food. Yeah. So it's important to reduce waste. Then, like you said, we could recycle, meaning the paper that you said, we could make something new out of it. Where we disintegrate, where we break down the paper and make something new out of it. That is something that is called recycling. And the third one is actually reusing, where the can that you said, what you have done is made a productive use out of the can. If you are making a pen stand or a binocular, what you're doing is upcycling, where you are making it into something useful. You know, you are reusing the same thing, but you're making it into something more beautiful and something that can be used. So I think it's a good idea for us to start thinking about reducing, reusing, and recycling. What do you think, Samir? And what do you guys think? I have some questions for you based on this story. Yes? So the first question is, I want you to identify five items in your house. It could be any five items. Yes, take down a pencil and a paper and note down the questions that I'm asking you. The first question is, of these five items, which of these five items can you live without? You know, items that you don't need to live exactly. The items that you can do without. You know, maybe you can say, I'm giving you an example. Suppose one of the items you have chosen is a comb. You may say, I have very short hair and I think I don't need a comb at all. I can live without a comb. Yes? So something like that. Of the five items, which of these can you live without? Those things obviously are not absolute necessities, correct? Those are things that we can do away with or not buy too many of. Now, your second question is, which of these items that are absolutely required, which of these items can be recycled, where they can be made into something completely new, broken down and made into, created into something new? Which of these items can be recycled? And your third question is, which of these items can you upcycle? Upcycle meaning where you reuse it and make it into something new, something different, but you are basically having it the same as it was. So something new that you can make out of the same can or whichever item that you are choosing. Can you think of different ways to upcycle these items? Maybe you could tell me those ways and we could see. So actually, I wanted to tell you, one of the things that I upcycle are my honey bottles. We buy a lot of honey at home. I have a little one at home and he has a lot of honey. So after the bottle of honey is over, what I do is do a lot of glass painting, decoupage and things like that and make it into flower vase. Yes, flower vase, vase. So that is one way in which I upcycle. How do you upcycle? Why don't you think of some ways and tell me? Yes? So Chitra, that was my story for the day.
Okay, awesome. So stories have, I think this concept of storytelling has also, you know, become integral part of a lot of our courses at Mango. So we're also, we've recently launched a new club for 5 to 7 year olds, which is Mango Science at Home Club, and you're one of the key mentors in the club. So I want to ask you to give us a little bit of information about the club and what it includes.
Okay. One thing is, I believe stories have a great impact, and the fact that stories, I think only recently we've moved into realizing that stories can teach you more than just morals. You know, the stories can be used to teach more than just morals, or maybe it was extended up to history. But stories can teach you science is something that we are only recently exploring. We have recently explored the idea, and it seems to work phenomenally well with the Mango Science Radio. So one of the things we decided to do is the club for Science at Home Club. It is for 5 to 7 year old children, and we have another club for 8 to 10 year old. In the 5 to 7 year old category, we have stories playing a predominant role, where we have some projects that the children, some stories that we will be telling the children based on certain key topics, which are aimed at building the curiosity of children towards science and also giving them certain certain important perspectives towards various aspects of science, math, and technology. So these stories are going to help them to do their projects. And we made a conscious effort to ensure that there is not too much screen time for the children, because as it is with everything going online, people are looking at, people are experiencing too much screen time. So especially since we have very young children involved in this Science at Home Club, we will be looking at very minimal screen time, more active engagement through offline projects. So we are also looking at how can we give this project such that it will be something that the child can do on a day-to-day basis. So on an everyday basis, there is something that the child will be involved in. Every month basis, there is a story that the child will be involved in. We are also looking at the parents playing a major role in this age group. So we are looking at it more as a co-op where the parents come forward. They also participate. They tell the stories along with their children. They participate in the learning of the child. And we are also looking at key workshops that we can hold for the parents so that they will be empowered enough to create a learning environment in their homes. So those are some of the key aspects of the club that we are looking at.
Okay, great. Now we'll just open the session to questions. So those of you who are watching, if you have any questions about the club or about Mango Science Radio or about stories in general, then you can probably put it up in the comments and we'll take it up for answering.
I have received a response from somebody saying that they like my stories very much. So whoever it was, and if that person is watching this live, thank you very much. You actually motivate me to tell more stories.
That's lovely. If you enjoyed the story and would like to interact more with Deepa, you can get in touch with her through the Science at Home Club. She's one of the mentors. And the club is designed for parents and children to learn together, like Deepa already mentioned. And if you want more details about the club or you want to check out the registration, then you can visit the link. It's given in the description. And we also have a free activity on the page. So you can try that out as a sample and you can let us know your thoughts. You can message us at 995-22-43541. And we'll respond if you have any queries as well.
It would also be great if they could tell us what kind of stories are they are liking, you know, stories with questions that are is it helping them learn better, or what kind of stories are helping them, you know, that could help us, that feedback could help us give a better experience to the listeners. So yes, you guys, if you have any feedback on, you know, you can just tell what kind of stories you like, and we will try to. If you have experienced a different kind of storytelling anywhere else also, please tell us and maybe we could try to incorporate that in our session.
Is there anything else that you would like to say?
I would like to talk of this clubs as a learning environment. I think clubs are a great way to engage children, get people to be, get children engaged in doing fun things and in things that interest them. It is not, I've always enjoyed being part of clubs in the school. There was a literacy club, there was the science club, there was the math club, and we could choose what we were interested in. So, and the age differences in the club, you know, there were older children, there are younger children. So the age difference adds, the variety adds a lot to the kind of experiences that you gather in the club. When you're in a class and learning science, I'm with my same age group of children. So the experience is completely driven by the teacher. Whereas a club has, you know, a more larger range of fun activities or challenging activities, and there is a different age range which gives you different perspectives. So club as a learning environment, I think, is a fantastic way to both have fun, get perspectives, and learn in a fun way, you know. Yeah, so that way choosing clubs is a great thing that Mango has. Choosing clubs as a way to deliver science is a great thing that Mango has done, I feel.
So I have a question for you. As far as I know, most of the stories that you have delivered for kids are all your creation. So you base them on a concept and you come up with a story. So I just wanted to know, when we specifically talk of science stories, what is the level of challenge that you face in coming up with a story based around the concept? Because a lot of concepts are very advanced and they involve a lot of elements, and to be able to explain that to kids is a little challenging. So what is the process that you go through to simplify the concept in the form of a story.
So one thing that it is sometimes very challenging to think of the right concept. One thing that I am guided by is trying to understand what is the basic upon which a child can build their own understanding. What is the kind of perspective that I can give upon which the child can develop his or her own understanding? So obviously the perspective that I give should also be in some way appropriate to the age level of the child. So like if you see these stories, whichever I have been delivering so far, I think they are simplistic enough for a child from age, I mean, my son is 4 years old, but he is able to grasp those concepts that I'm saying. But if you see the syllabus of, say, measurement or camouflage or even reduce, reuse, recycle, and these some of the things that I told stories upon are covered until age 10, until class 5. So I think it's more about the perspective and what they use to build their knowledge on, rather than a syllabus-based concept that I try to deliver.
All right. So just here's a quick timeline of our activities on YouTube. We go live every Tuesday. We upload science stories from our podcast, Mango Science Radio, which we're celebrating the 100 episodes of today. We upload the stories on YouTube on Wednesday and Saturday. And we also post snippets from our open house sessions, which happens on every Wednesday. So these snippets are posted on Monday. So if you'd like to receive notifications when these videos go up or every time we go live, then don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and, of course, hit the bell icon. And our Facebook viewers as well, please like, comment, and share this video with all the kids you know so that they can also enjoy the story and join the Mango Science Radio community. Also, like we already mentioned, you can check out the Mango Science at Home Club using the link in the description below. So, yes, thank you so much for being here. And thank you, Deepa, for the story. It was very nice.
Thank you very much. I hope to see all of these people on Science at Home Club.
Yes, and I hope everyone had a good time. And we will catch you on the next live. Bye-bye.